We're looking at Britten's Canticle I today, which is the first of five large-scale vocal works he wrote over a period of about 30 years. This one was composed in 1947. And I'm delighted to be joined today by tenor Matthew Sandy.
Hello, it's a pleasure to be back, as always.
It's lovely to have you here. And as this film is going out on Valentine's Day, we thought we would talk about why this piece is one of the most romantic things that Britten ever wrote.
A wonderful piece of music for Valentine's Day. The first thing I'd always have to go to is the text. The text just talks about, the first line of it is, even like two little bank divided brooks that wash the pebbles with their wonted streams, and having ranged and searched a thousand nooks, meet both at length at silver-breasted Thames. And that leads us into this whole text about how these two people in the text are joined in so many allegorical ways. The Canticle was written in 1947, and for those eagle-eyed mathematicians, that's 20 years before homosexuality was decriminalised partially in England and Wales. And of course there was the fantastic exhibition here at the Red House last year that commemorated that. And really what it's saying to me, certainly, and what I think that Britten is trying to say is, here is how I feel about this man that I'm performing with, that I've written this piece for. This text is more than romantic. It's not just a cartoon love. It's real, it's tangible, it's sacred. This is how I feel about him. This is how he feels about me.
So I, my best beloved, am